ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो, कम्स अंडर प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी रेशियो, है ना डियर चिल्ड्रन? द फॉर्मूला ऑफ ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो इज वेरी वेरी सिंपल। सिंपल ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इनटू 100 अपॉन आरएफओ, रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन, रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन। ओके, दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो। इवन ऑल प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी रेशियो, मैक्सिमम प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी रेशियो भी कंप्यूट इन दिस मैनर। इफ इट इज नेट प्रॉफिट रेशियो, नेट प्रॉफिट अपॉन आरएफओ इनटू 100। ऑपरेटिंग प्रॉफिट रेशियो, ऑपरेटिंग प्रॉफिट अपॉन आरएफओ इनटू 100, है ना? हाउ टू कैलकुलेट ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट, वी कैन सी हियर। इफ सेल्स इज गिवन, देन रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन माइनस कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड्स सोल्ड, यस और नो? एंड समटाइम्स डायरेक्ट परसेंटेज इज ऑल्सो गिवन टू कैलकुलेट ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट, सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट बाई यूजिंग दैट मैनर ऑल्सो, है ना? सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द क्वेश्चन, लेट्स सॉल्व सम न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑफ ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो। क्वेश्चन नंबर 113, कंप्यूट ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो फ्रॉम द फॉलोइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन। कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड इज गिवन 5,40,000 एंड रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन इज गिवन 6 लाख। कैलकुलेट ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो। सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 113, रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन इज गिवन 6 लाख एंड कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड इज ऑल्सो गिवन। कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड इज गिवन 5,40,000। When we subtract cost of goods sold from RFO, what we get? We get gross profit. So gross profit will be 60,000 in this condition. And formula of gross profit ratio is gross profit into 100 upon revenue from operations, RFO. So it will be 60,000. RFO is 66 lakh. Multiply by 100 and it is 10%. So the capacity of business to earn gross profit is 10%. The profitability ratio we express in terms of percentage. Okay, dear children, I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay, so let's begin another question. Question number 114. Question number 114. From the following, calculate gross profit ratio. In this question, gross profit is given directly. Revenue from operation is given 5 lakh and sales return is given 50,000. Dear children, revenue from operation means net sales. Revenue from operation means net sales, and the meaning of net sales is in which sales return is already deducted, already reduced. It means in this 5 lakh sales return is already reduced. So there is no need of this sales return. Is that clear? Anna, so in this question, gross profit ratio is equal to gross profit upon RFO multiply by 100 and gross profit is given 50,000 and RFO is given 5 lakh. Gross profit 50,000, revenue from operation 5 lakh. Multiply by 100 and your gross profit ratio is 10%. Very simple, hai na? I hope it is clear to everyone. Revenue from operation means net sales, and in net sales, sales return is already reduced, hai na? So let's move on another question. Question number 115. Okay. Yes. Question number 115. Compute gross profit ratio from the following information. Now revenue from operation is given here 4 lakh. Okay. Revenue from operation is given 4 lakh and gross profit is 25% on cost. So children, gross profit is 25%, but it is given on cost. And we do not know what is cost. Yes or no, dear children? But we know one thing, that there is some relationship between cost, gross profit and RF. What is that relationship? Suppose cost is X. Suppose we assume cost X. And when we add profit in cost, what we get? Profit is 25% on cost. So 25% of X means 25 upon 100. Or we can say 1 by 4 or we can say x by 4, yes or no? Cost plus profit is equal to sales or RFO. And RFO is given is 4 lakh, revenue from operation is given 4 lakh. So with this given information, we can easily compute COGS also and profit also. X plus x by 4, what we get? When we take LCM, we get 5x by 4. Is equal to 4 lakh, hai na? Yes or no? Let's cross multiply. When we cross multiply, what we get? 4 multiply by 4 lakh divide by 5, hai na? 5 8 ja 40, 80,000, and 8 4 ja 32, 3 lakh 20,000. So your cost of goods sold is 3 lakh 20,000. So what will be gross profit? The gross profit is 25% of cost. So 25% of 3,20,000. When we calculate 25%, 1 by 4, 4 8 year means 80,000. 80,000 is our gross profit. Now we can simply calculate gross profit ratio. Gross profit ratio means gross profit upon revenue from operation multiply by 100. Gross profit we have computed 80,000 and revenue from operation is given how much? 4 lakh. Revenue from operation is given 4 lakh multiply by 100. So what we get? 4 2 ja 8 means 20%. I hope it is clear to everyone. Question number 116. Calculate gross profit ratio from the following data. Cash sales are 20% of total sales. So this is given. Cash sales is 20% of total sales. Okay, dear children. Credit sales are 5 lakh. Credit sales are given 5 lakh. Purchases are given 4 lakh. Purchases are given 4 lakh. Excess of closing inventory over opening inventory is 25,000, isn't it? So opening inventory is X, suppose, then closing inventory will be X plus 25,000, isn't it or not? Excess of closing inventory over opening inventory, we need to calculate gross profit ratio. So what is needed to calculate gross profit ratio? Children, we need gross profit upon revenue from operation multiply by 100. So gross profit is needed and revenue from operation is needed. With this given information, we can calculate revenue from operation, because we know cash sales, total sales and credit sales, there is a relationship. Total sales minus cash sales is equal to credit sales. Yes or no? Total sales minus cash sales is equal to credit sales. This is what the relationship between these items. total sales is not given, so say, let us assume that so total sales is X. If total sales is X, cash sales is 20%. 20% means X by 5 is equal to credit sales, and credit sales is given in the question, that is 5 lakh. Let us solve this equation. X minus X by 5 is equal to 4X by 5 is equal to 5 lakh. Yes or no? Or X is equal to 5 into 5 lakh by cross multiplication, divide by 4. Isn't it or not? So let me solve. 25 lakh divide by 4 is equal to 6,25,000. So children, this is revenue from operation we have computed. Now we need to calculate gross profit. So first we need to calculate cost of goods sold, hai na? So, and purchase is given, you know, purchase is given, opening inventory is given, closing inventory is given. So we can calculate cost of goods sold. Yes or no? Hai na? So let's see what the formula we have. We have cost of goods sold is equal to opening inventory plus purchase minus closing inventory. So cost of goods sold is equal to opening inventory is X plus purchase is given, dear children, 4 lakh. Hai na? Purchase is given 4 lakh. 4 lakh minus closing stock is X plus 25,000. X plus 25,000. So let us solve this. Cost of goods sold is equal to X to X will be cancelled, and then 4 minus 25,000 when we open the bracket. So it would be 3,75,000. So cost of goods sold is now 3,75,000. So we can easily calculate gross profit. Gross profit can be computed by this revenue from operation minus cost of goods sold. And revenue from operation we have computed 6,25,000 minus 3,75,000. Let me solve. 6,25,000 minus 3,75,000 is equal to 2,50,000. So gross profit is also computed, revenue from operation is also computed. So we can easily calculate gross profit ratio. 2,50,000 divided by 6,25,000 multiply by 100 is equal to, let me check, is equal to 40%. So gross profit ratio is 40%. So children, I think the question is clear to everybody. So let's see one more question. Question number 117. From the following information, calculate gross profit ratio. What is given? Credit sales is given, purchase is given, carriage inward is given, decrease in inventory. Decrease in inventory means opening inventory plus purchase minus closing. So minus closing inventory. This is the meaning of decrease in inventory. It means opening inventory minus closing inventory is equal to 10,000. Return outward means purchase return, hai na? So we will subtract from purchase wages and rate of credit sale to cash sale. Credit sale is given 5 lakh. So we can calculate cash sale also by using this ratio, hai na? And that will be total sales. And cost of goods sold we will calculate by using purchase, carry inward, decrease in inventory and wages. And then we calculate gross profit. Very good question, dear. Very good question. Question number 117. So we need to calculate gross profit ratio. The formula is gross profit upon revenue from operation multiply by 100. First we calculate revenue from operation from the given information. Ratio of credit sale to cash sale. credit sale to cash sale. Their ratio is given how much? 4 is to 1. 4 is to 1 their ratio is given. And credit sale is given 5 lakh. Credit sale is given 5 lakh. Can we calculate cash sale? Yes, we can calculate simply by divided by 4, hai na? So cash sale will be 5 lakh divided by 4. So it will be 1,25,000. Cash sale is 1,25,000. Total sales means cash sale plus credit sale. Credit sale is given 5 lakh. And cash sale is given 1,25,000. So it will come 6,25,000. So this is your total sales. Now we need to calculate gross profit. So let us calculate cost of goods sold first in the given question. Cost of goods sold. Okay. So let us calculate cost of goods sold in the given question. Opening inventory minus closing inventory means decrease in inventory. Okay. Purchases 3 lakh. Purchases plus carriage inward. Then decrease in inventory means opening minus closing, this will be added, plus decrease in inventory. And return outward, we need to subtract it from purchases, hai na? Minus return from purchase, and then wages 50,000 plus wages. So this is the formula for this question. Okay, so let's solve it. COGS is equal to purchase is given 3 lakh. Minus return. What is return? 10,000. 290 plus carriage inward. 10,000 plus decrease in inventory. 10,000 plus wages 50,000. Yes or no? Wages 50,000. Right? Okay. Yes, let us solve. We get cost of goods sold. So 3 lakh minus 10, 290. 290 plus 10, 3 lakh. 3 lakh plus 10, 310. 3 lakh 60,000. Huh? So cost of goods sold is 3 lakh 60,000. Now we need gross profit. And we know the formula of gross profit is revenue from operation minus cost of goods sold. So gross profit will be RFO we have computed 6,25,000 minus cost of goods sold 3,60,000, hai na? So let us subtract it. 6,25,000 minus 3,60,000, so it is coming 2,65,000. So gross profit is 2,65,000, and so let's put in the formula. Gross profit is 2,65,000 upon net total sales is 6,25,000 multiply by 100. So let us solve it. 2,65 divided by is equal to 42.4%. Yes or no, dear children? I hope it is clear to everyone. Question number 118. From the following information, calculate gross profit ratio. Revenue from operation is given, cash and credit sales both are given. Purchase is given, cash credit. Carriage inward is given, salary is given. Decrease in inventory means opening inventory minus closing inventory. रिटर्न आउटवर्ड मीन्स परचेज रिटर्न, सो यू सब्ट्रैक्ट परचेज एंड देन वेजेस इज गिवन. दिस इज द क्वेश्चन विच केम इन सीबीएसई 2020 कंपार्टमेंट पेपर. यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो. ओके, ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो मीन्स वी नीड ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट अपॉन रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन मल्टीप्लाई बाय 100. So let us calculate revenue from operation. So in this question it is given directly cash and credit 2 plus 8, 2 lakh plus 8 lakh, 10 lakh. So RFO is given 10 lakh. Okay. Now we need to calculate gross profit. First we can calculate cost of goods sold. So in this question how can we calculate cost of goods sold? Purchase is given. 360 plus 40, 4 lakh. Purchase minus purchase return, return outward 20,000 minus 20,000. And now this is purchase minus purchase return plus carriage inward is direct expenses 8,000. Carriage inward. Salary is indirect expenses, it will not come. Hana, it is indirect expenses and indirect expenses are not recorded in calculation of cost of goods sold. Decrease in inventory, 1,22,000 will be added, opening minus closing inventory plus 1,22,000 and wages will come 20,000. Wages 20,000. Let's calculate cost of goods sold. So 3,80,000 plus 1,30,000 plus 20,000. So it is coming 5,30,000. Cost of goods sold is 5,30,000. Let's calculate gross profit. Gross profit is equal to revenue from operation minus cost of goods sold. And revenue from operation is computed 10 lakh and cost of goods sold is computed 5,30,000. So what we get? We get 4,70,000, hai na? So let's calculate gross profit ratio. Gross profit is 4,70,000. Just a minute. 4,70,000 divided by 10 lakh multiply by 100 is equal to 47%. I hope it is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's continue with the next, है ना? Next question. Question number 119. Opening inventory is given 2 lakh. Okay. Question number 119. Opening inventory is given 2 lakh. Closing inventory is given 1,20,000. Closing inventory is given 1,20,000. Inventory turnover ratio is given 8 times. Inventory turnover ratio is given 8 times. Selling price 25% above cost. And selling price how 25% above cost. 25% above cost. Okay, so these are the information and we need to calculate gross profit ratio. See, we know that gross profit ratio means we need gross profit upon revenue from operation into 100. So with this given information, dear children, we can calculate cost of goods sold. Because ITR is given inventory turnover ratio. The formula of inventory turnover ratio is कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड अपॉन एवरेज इन्वेंट्री, है ना। इन्वेंट्री टर्नओवर रेशियो इज गिवन 8 times, सो वी कैन कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड अपॉन एवरेज इन्वेंट्री, एंड एवरेज इन्वेंट्री वी कैन कंप्यूट। एवरेज इन्वेंट्री मीन्स ओपनिंग इन्वेंट्री प्लस क्लोजिंग डिवाइड बाय 2। तो ओपनिंग इन्वेंट्री इज 2 lakh, क्लोजिंग इन्वेंट्री इज 1,20,000 डिवाइड बाय 2, है ना। सो डिवाइड बाय 2, सो लेट अस डिवाइड, 2 प्लस 1 3,20,000 डिवाइड बाय 2 इज इक्वल टू 1,60,000। सो दिस इज योर एवरेज इन्वेंट्री, सो 1,60,000 इज एवरेज इन्वेंट्री। कैन वी कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड? यस, वी कैन कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड इज इक्वल टू 1,60,000 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 8, मल्टीप्लाई इट ट्वेल्व लैख एटी थाउजेंड इज कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड, है ना। यस और नो? नाउ कॉस्ट ऑफ गुड सोल्ड इज कंप्यूटेड, देर इज वन इंफॉर्मेशन विच इज गिवन, सेलिंग प्राइस इज 25% अबव कॉस्ट, इट मीन्स ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज 25% ऑफ 1,280,000। So we can calculate gross profit 1,280,000 into 25%. Let's calculate 1,280,000 into 25%, 3,20,000. So this is our gross profit. Gross profit is also computed. Can we calculate sales? Yes. RFO can also be calculated by COGS plus gross profit. COGS is given 1,280,000 and gross profit is given 3,20,000. Let us add 12, 3, 15, 16, 16 lakh. 16 lakh is your RFO, revenue from operation, hai na? So, and 3,20,000 is gross profit. So let us put in formula 3,20,000 divide by 16 lakh multiply by 100. So 16 to 32, it means 20%. So 20% is your gross profit ratio. I hope it is clear to everyone. Dear children, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's see the next question number 120. One more question, let's see. A trader carries an average inventory of 1 lakh. So average inventory is given here in this question, number 120. Average inventory is given 1 lakh. Okay. His inventory turnover ratio is 8 times. Okay. Inventory turnover ratio is 8 times. He sells goods at a profit of 25% on cost. Okay. Calculate gross profit ratio. Very simple. We know the formula of ITR. COGS upon average inventory. By using this formula, we can calculate cost of goods sold. 8 cost of goods sold upon average inventory 1 lakh, and cost of goods sold will be 1 lakh into 8 lakh. And according to the given information, goods profit at a profit of 25% on cost means 25% is profit. So gross profit will be 25% of 8 lakh into 25% means 1 by 4 means 2 lakh. So gross profit is 2 lakh एंड आर एफ ओ मीन्स सीओजीएस प्लस ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट, यस और नो? सो इट विल बी 8 लाख प्लस 2 लाख इज इक्वल टू 10 लाख. सो 10 लाख इज योर आर एफ ओ, ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज 2 लाख. सो यू कैन इजिली कैलकुलेट ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो. ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट रेशियो इज इक्वल टू ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इन टू 100 अपॉन रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन, है ना? ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट इज 2 लाख, रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम ऑपरेशन इज 10 लाख, मल्टीप्लाई बाय 100 इज इक्वल टू 20%. यस डियर चिल्ड्रन, आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन.